heart rate.
Okay, great. Let's set him up a little bit. Let's get some fluids going on. We don't got fluids, we're going to get those in a couple minutes.
Really, the goal of everything that we do in our simulation center is ensuring patient safety because, as we know, hospital errors and healthcare facility errors are a major concern nationwide.
The current generation of students no longer want to sit in a classroom. They want hands-on experience. They learn by doing. The lab provides that opportunity.
With the technology here, we're able to simulate a true patient encounter, which also helps us gain confidence in talking to patients.
We have some very exciting manikins. Our first state-of-the-art manikin would be Hal, our pediatric manikin. He has over 26 to 27 different facial expressions, heart sounds, lung sounds, bowel sounds. And what this allows us to do is to give the student a perspective of working on a pediatric patient. One of our other manikins, Victoria, is a state-of-the-art birthing mother. What's great about her is when you come in the room, Victoria will actually follow the students around the room with her eyes. After she gives birth, Victoria will actually mimic a hemorrhage situation, which is the type of situations we want our nurses to be aware of. Victoria will also give birth to a baby that the student nurses will actually be able to assess heart sounds, lung sounds, Apgar score, and they'll actually get a full experience of delivering a baby without actually having a real mother in the room to deliver.
They can run scenarios like run a code blue, and we learn to adapt to those situations. They can, you know, change the patient's vital signs and how would we respond to that. So it's a really great learning environment, especially before going into the clinical setting and working with real patients. It's really good to have this experience beforehand.
Clinical courses are an important part of nurse practitioner training, and when the pandemic came along and the clinical rotations were put on pause, the majority of our students still had 150 or more hours remaining to graduate from the program. So as a result of this telehealth training, we were able to assist our students in developing competencies in providing healthcare through telecommunication. And then we were able to match those students up with providers in the community who were delivering telehealth services to their patients.
Nothing can replace actual patient care, but simulation is the next best thing and also provides them with a safe space.
This is where you can make mistakes. So after they participate in the simulation, the students come together and they debrief. And that is where true learning takes place.
When they get into the hospital, we don't want them to be focusing on technology. We want them to focus on the patient. So if they're comfortable with technology, they can really shift their focus to taking care of the patient.